Hands down, it is one of the greatest trailers ever. But is the film as good as the trailer? This is my review of The Tree of Life. Welcome to another episode of Film Trash Review. Today's review, Tree of Life. To be able to appreciate this film, you have to understand where this film came from. Terrence Malick has had over 45 plus years in the film industry. So how many films has he made as a director? This is his fifth. Yeah. He started with the idea of Tree of Life back in 2005, and at first, Heath Ledger was on the project. But because Terrence Malick takes his time doing his films, Heath Ledger is no longer with us. And so in 2008, he went out to find a replacement for Heath Ledger, and that ended up being Brad Pitt. They started filming in 2008 for this film, and ended by the end of 2008. In 2009, it was expected to get a release, but couldn't find a distributor for the US. It found a distributor in everywhere else except for the UK and the US. So basically, after that, Terrence Malick went on a huge hunt to try to find a distributor, and he found one. So this film was supposed to be released at the end of 2009. December 25th. It was supposed to be a Christmas film. For whatever reason, the film never was released then, and it was pushed back to the Cannes Film Festival in France in 2010. It just wasn't ready. Basically, this film made its debut at the Cannes Film Festival in 2011, finally, and it did great, and the critics have been all over it since then. So, does the film live up to the hype? It was talked about that Terrence Malick said that the original cut of this film, the first cut of this film, was 8 hours long. That is insanely crazy. And now there's talks that he's going to use an extended cut, like a director's cut, that's 6 hours long. I gotta say, I would watch 6 hours of Tree of Life. It was that good. It was really good. The film starts out with a man played by Sean Penn, and his dad is played by Brad Pitt, and he's just recalling his childhood and losing his innocence in his childhood. And it's just a basic storyline like that. And it has really experimental things with it. Like for the first 20 minutes or so, it has this 2001 Space Odyssey type feel to it, and they go through like the beginning of time and all of that, which I thought could have been just thrown out entirely because I didn't care for it at all. It just was irrelevant, and we at least saw two people leave the theater because of this. You're just not able to hold an audience that long, Terrence. You're not able to hold them that long, but once you get past that 25 minute mark, this film is amazing. It is mind-blowing. Just the cinematography itself by Terrence Malick and his films is bar none. I mean, if you just watch The Thin Red Line. Just watch The Thin Red Line and you will understand what The Tree of Life is going to give you. This simple plot is able to become something so complex because of it. Able to become like this Bible of what life means. The acting performances were phenomenal. I mean, even the 3 to 4 year old I think he was supposed to be playing. That kid, man, I cannot believe like some of the emotion coming off of his face when that camera came up to him. This is a definitely well-acted film. You have to act well for something like this to be pulled off, and they did. They pulled it off. They pulled it off entirely. Basically, at first, I was going to give this film a 9 out of 10 because of that first 20 minutes, but then I realized there's so much to discuss with this. I found myself searching on IMDb for meanings and the meanings and deeper and deeper and deeper meanings of this film and how many people are really discussing this film thoroughly. How many critics gave a review of this film and gave it more than 1 to 2 pages long? Nobody's gonna write more than 4 paragraphs about Cars 2. This thing is such a discussion maker. It has such a higher meaning that I gotta give this film a 10 out of 10. Breaking it down now, Tree of Life is an amazing, artful piece of magic. You just gotta see it. If you haven't seen it, you're gonna have to hunt for it in theaters. It's not in very many theaters around the world right now. But it is definitely something to go see, and something that I hope gets a lot of Oscar nominations come this February. All right, this has been my review of Tree of Life. We will be back with our review of Winnie the Pooh.